Leslie, good morning.
Hi, Michael. Hi, Tina. How are you?
Good morning, Leslie. Doing well. Thank you.
Good.
We, as always, every week, we solicit on Twitter, Michael and Gina, or on Facebook page, Michael and Gina. We always solicit a question of the week, relationship question of the week for our expert, Leslie Vernick. And this week, it comes from Julie in Bloomfield Hills, and she writes, is it possible to change a toxic relationship or, Leslie, as you would refer to them, emotionally destructive? Is it possible to change a toxic relationship into a healthy one?
Well, I think it is. And let me just say that the key to unlocking a stuck relationship that's toxic is to know that the change begins with you. Even though you don't see yourself as the toxic person or you don't see yourself as the unhealthy person, the first thing that someone has to look at when they're in a long-term relationship with someone who's toxic is what's my part? You know, when we're a repeated victim of someone or we're in a repeated relationship that's destructive, we need to ask ourselves, you know, what's my part? Am I being passive? Am I not setting good boundaries? Have I been allowing this person to continue to hurt me without protest? And so when you begin to identify your part, you realize that you can begin to change your part. And when you're dancing with someone, for example, and you start to change your own dance steps, then the relationship changes. You can't continue to dance the same way. Now, I'm not saying it changes for the better always, mm-hmm. but the relationship does start to change. And so when you're in a toxic relationship with someone, the very first thing that you can begin to do is own your part, and you can initiate and invite someone else to begin to change as you change, and then the dance begins to change. Now, that's not a guarantee that it changes for the better, but it does start to change the relationship. And so I want to share three things that someone can do to begin to invite this kind of change.
Great. I love it. Let's get our pencils out.
Okay. The first thing that you can start to do is if you're recognizing your part, you speak up. You say, you know what? I don't like the way we're dancing. I'm not happy with you stepping on my toes. This hurts me. I'm uncomfortable with this. I don't like myself this way. I don't like that I've become so passive or so childlike in this relationship. Whatever it is, your part, you speak up and you say you don't like this. Now, if you're with a relatively healthy person, they'll hear that and they'll begin to respect that. That doesn't mean that they'll change automatically, but once you start saying, I don't like this, ouch, please stop doing this, most healthy people will try to accommodate that, and all you'll have to do is to continue to remind them. However, when you're with a toxic person, they often really don't care that they step on your toes, and they really don't want to stop the dance the way they're doing it, and so they'll try to get you to change back. And that's where it's important. If you speak up and you're not being heard, the very next step you have to do is you have to stand up and set some boundaries. And boundaries are really important, and there's a lot of discussion about boundaries, but you set a boundary on yourself, not on the other person. For example, you say something like, I won't let myself be treated this way anymore. You can't say, I won't let you treat me this way anymore, because you really don't have control over the other person. But you can say, I won't stay and talk to you if you continue to talk to me this way.
That sounds so simple, but we usually do not think of it that way, do we? We don't look at ourselves often. We look at the other person, how we can change them.
And it's such a frustrating thing because we can't change the other person. We can influence them and we can invite them to change. But the only person that we can change is us. And so when you change your dance steps, like I said, the relationship will begin to change. And sometimes it actually gets a little tenser for a while because the other person isn't sure you really mean it. And so if you speak up and you stand up and put a boundary down, and if this person continues to disrespect your boundaries and is continuing to not change and be toxic towards you, the last step that you do to continue to change the relationship, if possible, is that you initiate consequences. You step back and you say, I cannot continue to be close to you in a relationship. Jesus says when someone sins against us, we're supposed to go to them and talk to them. And if they hear us, that's a speak up part that we've won their fellowship back. But if they refuse to listen, then he says there's consequences to that. You go to the church and those kind of things. And if they still refuse to listen, he says treat them as he would a pagan or a tax collector. So the relationship, the quality of the relationship, and the fellowship of the relationship is different. It changes. And those consequences are meant to also bring this person back into repentance that they will begin to own their part and change.
Right. Well, when the question came up this week, when I saw that on Facebook, I thought to myself, I wonder if we could tag the word alone to the end of the question just to make it read, is it possible to change a toxic relationship into a healthy one alone? Meaning doing it yourself. And I guess this is when you get to this point, that's when it really, you are kind of alone in that.
You are alone, and you can't change the relationship into a healthy relationship all by yourself. What you can do is you change your part. So the relationship becomes a better relationship all by yourself. And so what I say is you can make a bad relationship better all by yourself. You cannot make a bad relationship a good relationship all by yourself.
Right. Right. Well, I have a friend who went through a divorce, and after the divorce was finalized, she had gone into therapy and became a really healthy person. Mm-hmm. And I only thought to myself, if only that had taken place 5 years earlier, this marriage could have been saved.
Absolutely. So I think it's really important that we take responsibility for our part, and as we get healthier, oftentimes that is the example in the light another person needs, because they haven't learned to be healthy either. And that invites them, or that helps them to say, you know, I like the changes this person's making. I might not always like that they set boundaries on me or that they speak up, but I can see the health of that, and I want to learn to do that too.
Right. Well, Leslie, as always, you give such good advice and you have such wisdom, and we really appreciate it. The book that many of these ideas have come from is called The Emotionally Destructive Relationship. It's Seeing It, Stopping It, Surviving It. And it's a fantastic book, and I encourage anyone listening to pick it up. It addresses this exact issue. So with that, Leslie, we'll say thank you again, and we will talk with you next week.
Okay.
Thanks so much, Leslie.
Thanks.